Hi, and welcome to Retro Eric. In today's episode, it's all about the latest MIDI synthesizer from Serdashop, the DreamBlaster X16. Serdashop has specialized in making MIDI synthesizers for the WaveBlaster connector, or as we call it today, the WaveTable header. His WaveTable products ranges from the McFly, E-Wave, Q-Wave, the DreamBlaster S2, the DreamBlaster X2, and now the DreamBlaster X16. So, what makes the X16 so special? To explain it easy, the X16 has the best hardware specs for any WaveTable synth out there, as far as I know. And the version I'm testing today has the licensed GS ROM from Roland. It's based on the Dream 5000 series synth chip, which is used in professional synths and even pianos. It has 1 whole gigabyte of flash memory for sound fonts, so you can upload the highest quality sound fonts out there. It can play 256 notes at the same time, has super low latency, and a built-in digital-to-analog converter so that you can bypass the sound card for optimum sound quality. My recordings are taken directly from the X16's DAC. As we can see, it has 5 banks. If you opted for the GS version of the X16, you get a real licensed GS bank from Roland. And it comes pre-installed with a general MIDI sound font and a burn sound font. If you have seen my previous video on the DreamBlaster X2, you already know the burn sound font. It also has a sound font that tries to emulate an OPL3 FM synthesizer. And for extra fun, we have a sound font that emulates the 8-bit Nintendo sound chip, for the real nostalgic 8-bit sound feeling. If you're looking for the most authentic sound for your DOS games, you should probably go for the X16 with the official Roland GS license soundbank. Let's listen to Doom with the licensed GS soundbank. Changing soundbanks from DOS is super easy. Sadako has made MIDI files that when you play them, you are choosing which bank to use. You can basically use any MIDI player to send these commands to the DreamBlaster X16. There's also a DOS tool especially for sending commands to MIDI devices. After changing the preset to General MIDI in Bank 2, let's play some more Doom music. And since the Björn sound font have some nice guitar sample, let's listen to Doom again with the Björn sound font. Before we play more music, let's connect it to a modern Windows PC and look at the configuration tools. Once connected to Windows with a USB cable, it pops up in the hardware list as a MIDI synthesizer. This means that you can use the DreamBlaster X16 as output for MIDI music in any Windows MIDI players, DOSBox, and even SCUMM. In the Windows utility that you can download from Sedaco's webpage, we can see the soundbanks and the sound fonts that are already installed. As we can see in Bank 1, we have the licensed Roland GS version 1.4. It's stored in ROM, so it cannot be changed. In Bank 2 to 5, we have different sound fonts. With these tools, you can add and replace banks with whatever sound font you like. In the descriptions, you will find link to more and unofficial sound banks. Check them out. There is also a preset editor, where we can change signal processing for each soundbank. Actually, when changing soundbank from the MIDI commands I showed earlier, we are actually changing the presets. And each preset is connected to one soundbank. You can also change the default bank by using the dip switches on the card. Let's change to bank 5 for some chiptune music. Superplex is actually made to play with general MIDI. But I thought that using Bank 5, we make Superplex sound more like an 80s arcade machine. Listen. No sound card video is complete without playing some Monkey Island. So I found this Monkey Island special edition, or the talkie edition, and we are listening to it in general MIDI. We have now covered the basics on the card. I feel that my recordings don't give this card justice. Especially the licensed Roland GS bank sound fantastic. Playing music like the loud and fast music from Doom, many cards sounds good. But when playing classical music, the X16 really shines. this stage, I could start comparing it with other Wavetable synths. But this video is long enough, and I am working on a new video where I compare several different synths for the Wavetable header. Check that out. That's it for this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please like and subscribe.